sure why, because it's a Norwegian man who slipped abortion pills into his ex-girlfriend's smoothie, causing her to have a miscarriage, claims that it was the only way out. The 26-year-old apparently pleaded guilty on Monday to inflicting serious bodily harm and also terminating a pregnancy without the mother's consent. The prosecution wants a 7-year sentence.
Wow.
I'm not sure what the good time or the parole systems are in Norway, but I imagine they're probably pretty lenient. I wouldn't know. The 20-year-old woman lost the baby in her 12th week of pregnancy following the man's second attempt to sneak her abortion pills. The first time he tried passing off the pills, which he had bought online, as painkillers. He tried several times to convince me, this is a quote from her, that to have an abortion, but it was not an option for me, the woman told a court in Trondheim, reports the Norwegian public broadcaster NRK. After drinking the smoothie, the woman experienced severe abdominal pain and later miscarried that evening.
Oh, wow. So it wasn't like it took it a while to take effect. I gotcha.
Yeah, I would think that, when you're talking about terminating a 12-week pregnancy, this isn't plan B here.
I see.
This is something a bit more.
Huh.
So she said she had severe abdominal pain, and I'll take her word for that. She asked her doctor to run several tests, which confirmed that the miscarriage had been induced by a high dose of abortion medicine. Mm-hmm. The man told a Norwegian court he had a bad conscience and felt remorse, but I thought it was the only way out. I read online that pills could cause deformities if they did not work. After the first attempt didn't work, I thought it was my fault and that the child would be born with major malformations. I would not be able to live with that, so I decided to try again. I felt like a total S-bag when it dawned on me what I had done. The man's lawyer told the newspaper here that his client deserved leniency. It's totally wrong with a sentence of 7 years, especially.
So he's pled guilty. He has not yet been sentenced. Is that right?
That's correct.
Okay.
And the lawyer's claiming that since he confessed and has custody over a child from before, that he should get leniency. So there you go.
Well, it's certainly true that if he's in prison, he's not going to be very effective at sending any kind of monetary payments to the lady. I mean,
I'm not sure it's her child that he has. He has a child from before.
Not sure if it's his child. No. What I mean is, the baby's gone. Never mind. I'm sorry. Right.
Mother, I suppose, there's some. It would be very difficult to quantify what the damages are for a woman who lost a, for terminating a woman's pregnancy. But I think really what this comes down to is our whole.
You could claim the damages were 18 years of child support payments.
I suppose. I mean, what would you have a child to have child support payments for? And the child support payments would go to take care of the child. I think that's, I don't know, sounds like a crazy thing to me.
Just picking a number.
Yeah. No, I think that for me, what the problem is the whole system, the way it's set up. I mean, this guy saw this child as a threat, legitimately.
Yeah.
It was a threat to 18 years worth of child support payments to him. And clearly, he didn't have that big of an attachment to this particular relationship if he was willing to basically poison this woman. Mm. So, and she sees, the system basically threatens her in this way. I mean, the guy took really extreme measures. So I think the problem is that she gets to make a decision to abort a pregnancy on up to about the four and a half month mark, depending on what jurisdiction she's in. And he lost his decision at the moment of, ejaculation. You have the law treating two different sets of people differently here. And this is what he was faced with in his mind. I am not justifying this. I think that this is, in my opinion, ending a human life is ending a human life. But I'm looking at the system and I'm seeing what caused him to react the way he did, and wondering if there's not some better way of handling this.
Handling a situation where a dad or one person in the relationship does not want a child, but the other person does. Handling that to the satisfaction of both parties,
yes.
You mean?
See, she gets to decide whether or not a child's born. He doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
And
but yet he will have to be forced to pay if the child is born.
And that's indeed true. Yeah, people can say that he should keep it in his pants, but she didn't keep it in her pants either. So two to tango and all that stuff. So I think this is a dilemma, and I think the best solution for it is for
sex robots.
Certainly the future will bring those. There's quite a video on that. Anyway, the you know, I think that that's probably going to come. But I think that what the solution is that a man should be able to go to a courthouse and disclaim responsibility for a child up until the same moment that in any jurisdiction that a woman could go and get an abortion.
But, I mean, the people are going to say, wait a minute, Mark. I mean, that would essentially mean that a man can go around and knock up a bunch of women and have no responsibility for it, right? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I mean, you probably should know with whom you're having sex, right? As a person, mm-hmm. you should know whether or not somebody's going to take responsibility. And you should know, at the very least, maybe there should be a certain period of warning. Maybe it's 7 days less than a woman has or something like that, so that she has time to go and decide whether or not she wishes to abort the child because the father won't take care of it. I don't know.
Yeah, I just don't. I mean, it's not obviously going to be an unpopular. That's going to be an unpopular position, I think, to take.
It's an unpopular position, but
that the guy should be able to opt out, well, so to speak, after he already opted in by having the sexual intercourse in the first place. I mean, you know the risks, right? If you're going to be having intercourse, even if it's with a condom, there are still some risks. You know, and baby is one of those risks.
Well, nobody wants my opinion on this because I already
believe... Well, you're a talk show host, so you're going to have to give us your opinion.
But I'd say that the fact is that you know, if it has 46 chromosomes, it's human life. At, you know, two cells and a zygote, as far as I'm concerned, it's human life. So, you know, I can see why it's a big pain in the butt to raise a child, but I think that, adoption should have been on the table or something here.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. When you say adoption should be on the table, what do you mean?
Well,
in this situation.
In this case, if he could have given up paternity to the woman, like, wouldn't she have taken that as an option? Hey, you know, either I'm going to poison you and kill the baby, or...
Well, that's a threat, right? You don't just tell your loved one, hey, I'm going to poison you if you don't do what I want.
The whole thing is a threat. That's what I'm trying to say, is there is an implicit threat here laid out, and it's, you know, it's due to the actions of these people.
But it's not due to the actions of those people. It's due to the state, the fact that this system exists that is the actual threatening mechanism against either one partner or the other or both.
Don't you think that people have to be responsible for their actions, though?
Yeah, I think so. And I think the sex was what they were responsible for. I mean, when you have sex with somebody,
If it's
male-female sex and there's intercourse involved, then there's a chance that a baby's going to get made, and then the state's going to get real deeply involved in your relationship. And that's not okay. I'm not justifying the state's involvement, but at the same time, I think there's an argument to be made that both parties should be held responsible for that act.
There you go.
And I understand your point is that the lady is able to make a choice longer than the man is about whether or not the fetus lives or dies. But I think that's just sort of part and parcel to the whole process of, well, she's the one carrying the fetus, so shouldn't she be able to make that choice?
I'm not claiming she shouldn't be able to make that choice.
You're saying he should be able to opt out.
That's what
I think is going to make people really angry.
That's really right, because he's a deadbeat or whatever. And I mean,
well, wouldn't that encourage? I mean, the argument would be that would encourage more deadbeats if a guy could just be like,
I don't really care. I don't really care if it encourages deadbeats or not. But let me ask you this question though: if a woman chooses to abort a fetus because it will be inconvenient, which is basically what this guy's claim is here, if she aborts a child because it's inconvenient, is she then not a deadbeat by the same definitions?
Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE if you want to answer Mark's question or share your thoughts on this in general, or you can completely bring up anything you want.
She's making good life choices in that circumstance. He's a deadbeat.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Is Mark onto something here, or is he just totally whacked out? Wrong cough button there, buddy. Pay attention.
Sorry, I pushed the wrong button.
Yes, we'll come back with more Free Talk Live in moments. Free Talk Live.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org. ALCOR.ORG. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lawns to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Should you be able to earn an honest living free from senseless government interference? The Institute for Justice thinks so. That's why we've spent years defending hard-working men and women from pointless government regulations. Nationwide, IJ has created opportunity by reducing government power. But there is still more work to be done. Visit our website today at ij.org. Let IJ take care of the government so you can take care of your business.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. And some of our listeners tonight may be kicking back, enjoying the show with a bottle of CH wine. Or maybe just a glass of CH wine. Because if you go through one of those bottles, you will be... You'll be pretty drunk.
Yeah, sure.
It's good wine, and you know, it's actually got a fair amount of alcohol in it, which is what pieces me, Mark. I mean,
does that mean value to you? When something has more.
I'm not a wine connoisseur.
Ridiculous is what that is.
But you know, this actually has like 40% more alcohol than the boxed wine that, that I drank in the past. But it's also a really great wine too.
It's about the taste. Okay, if you're drinking wine for the alcohol content, you know, just
isn't
go ahead and get yourself some Everclear, boy. I mean,
well, right. Wine tastes better than Everclear, right?
Yeah. And, so that's what we're talking about here. Yeah. And this wine is far better. It's basically $70 to $100 bottles of wine that Carmen Hughes has gone around
Cameron.
to Cameron Hughes has gone around and to top vineyards and picked out, you know, basically their overstock and put his private label on it so that you wouldn't know which vineyards they were.
It's coming from a fancy vineyard, but you don't get to know which one, essentially.
That's important
so
to them
get it
as
for
the vineyards.
A fraction of the cost of what you would pay for it if you actually got it from the fancy vineyard. Instead, you go to chwine.com, put in code FTL. And then you can ship as much of it to yourself as you like. When you use code FTL, however, it gets you free shipping. So that's a huge deal. I mean, already these are incredible prices on great bottles of wine and all kinds of fancy types. Like, you know, I'm not a wine guy, so there was a triage. That's apparently a kind of wine in addition to saving people's lives.
Many of these are 90 points and above.
I don't know. What kind of rating scale
I don't really know much beyond that, but I'm just, you know, I'm throwing it out there like I know
we
something.
Need to figure
it was
that
really
out,
great
Mark.
Wine, though.
chwine.com. The code is FTL, like Free Talk Live, for free shipping. But keep in mind that free shipping offer is a limited time offer. So people have been ordering. And apparently, Mark, you said they gave you some feedback. Like, this has been a very successful.
Extraordinarily successful. Mm-hmm. Our listeners apparently are a bunch of lushes. We are on in the evening when people might be thinking about
wine
a little more.
Like I was saying, kick back, enjoy Free Talk Live with some CH Wine. Go to chwine.com, use code FTL to get the free shipping and do it sooner rather than later so you don't miss out. We've got Brendan on the line in Kentucky. Brendan, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hi, guys. Thanks for taking my call.
Welcome, sir.
I had a question. The case you were discussing, which was pretty fascinating. One of you was kind of talking about how the father – I'm sorry, I'm a first-time listener as well as caller.
Oh, welcome.
So I don't know your names yet.
Oh, you're shocked. It's Ian and Mark. Go ahead.
Okay. And, yeah, I'm not entirely familiar – you know, with all, you know, I'm sure your regular listeners know more about your views and stuff. You made a comment that, you know, the father felt threatened by this unborn child, et cetera, et cetera. And that one of the threats was that, you know, the state would require him to take responsibility for it, right?
Correct.
Right. So, I kind of got the impression there that you felt like the state should not require people or be involved in people to take responsibility for their children.
Well, what I would say
is that you may not even think that there should be a state at all.
I would probably say that. The difficulty that I would have there is that the state is currently sort of the dispute resolution organization du jour as far as these situations go. And I think people should be responsible for their actions, right? So I'm of the opinion that when you participate in the sex act, you have a reasonable assumption that a pregnancy might result. So therefore, everybody should take responsibility for their actions. However, we live in a world where one gender has the option of terminating the pregnancy up till, depending on the jurisdiction, the middle of the second trimester. The other gender doesn't have that option, so you're going to have these sort of conflicts, I guess, is what the reason I brought this up.
And I agree that there's certainly conflict there. I guess I was just kind of curious concerning. And, you know, this is a new kind of idea to me. I haven't explored a whole lot of, real deep stateless type thoughts. So, like, how does that work in an environment where there's nobody to, you know, kind of mandate that you take responsibility for your children?
That's an excellent question. So the question is, how would, the question of who has rights of a child or payments to one parent or another, how would something like that exist in the absence of having this monopoly court system that we currently have today? Which, by the way, many people find very, very unsatisfactory. There are so many people who...
Yeah, I don't doubt it.
Yeah, I mean, there are so many people, males and females both, who've been through the family court system, and it has just ruined them. So there's no doubt the current system leaves a lot to be desired. So the question is, how can getting away from a monopoly court system like the government system we have improve the situation between disputing parents or, you know, a deadbeat dad, that kind of thing? And I think that's an excellent question. I'd like to throw it out to our audience. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Like, sort of the pat answer for me is going to be, well, you know, the market will come up with ways to ostracize people. But that's just sort of a blow-off. I don't have anything much better than that. Mark, what do you think?
Well, right. I don't, you know, all I would say is that I don't propose that we get rid of government. I only propose that we get rid of an organization that claims a monopoly privilege on governing. That the idea 400 years ago that people of different religions would live in the same sort of local geographic area seemed kind of ridiculous when Quakers were getting killed by Puritans and when Catholics were at war with Protestants. This seemed really, really radical. But now we have, you know, all these people are sort of living together just fine. Could we not have places, could we not have a place where people had different governments that they just sort of contracted with?
So would this, would that mean like you have like an insurance company that you'd sign up with, and then as part of the terms you would agree that if you impregnate someone as a male that you'd be responsible for the
Use the term government because it because people can really understand it. So I would say that you would have the governments would function similar to insurance companies in that you would contract with them, and that sort of thing is what I'm imagining here, and that what we would have is competition in the marketplace and they would figure it out. I think that it is a very that abortions themselves are very contentious issues, and probably would not cease to be contentious in an you know, in a society where an organization wasn't, you know, didn't claim a monopoly like a state. So
what about
What
about somebody who had seceded? Hold on, I've got a question for Mark here, Brendan. What about somebody who secedes for the all the way from all governments, meaning that they are their own government, their own self-government, and they don't want to sign up with one of your governments that are out there in the marketplace? Would someone have to then, you know, if there was another person who wanted to have sex with that person, would they have to ask if they were covered by a government before they allowed them to commit intercourse? Because then, you know, how do you collect on that if the person hasn't made an agreement to this matter?
I would say that everybody's taking their chances when you're dealing with somebody who has no law. When you're dealing with an outlaw, literally, that's what that terminology means. When you're dealing with an outlaw, you get what you get.
So it's your mind that in the future, in this world that you're talking about, people who were going to have sex with one another would want to check and make sure they had their coverage first. Is that right?
They probably have some kind of uninsured humper coverage, but yeah.
Brendan, stand by. I know you had another question, so we'll bring you back here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What would making a baby look like, and all the issues that can come up with that between people? What would it look like without a monopoly over protection services and justice services? That's the question here. You can share your thoughts at Free Talk Live.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
This is Tim Austin, Senior Vice President of Kmart. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. As a business leader, I know that babies born very sick or too soon cost businesses billions of dollars each year. That's why Kmart is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
If you're looking for work, it's a process of elimination, and you're trying not to be eliminated. So here's a tip for making the cut, and this might seem subtle, but to the person interviewing you, it's not. There is a world of difference between applicants who convey, "I need a job," and those who simply ooze, "I want to work," especially in these lean times when many you're competing with will seem desperate in "I'll take anything" mode. If you convey specific interest in this job at this company, you will be conspicuous. Thus, the value of going to school on the company you're applying to before the interview. With money and attention so tight now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
It's not just zoning rules, it's everything.
It's true.
It's everything. There's so many rules. You can't possibly know them. It's physically an impossibility to know the laws. You know not to hurt other people. I don't need a law telling me to do that. But the rest of them? Totally inaccessible.
It's true.
It's written in legalese. If you don't have training in reading that crap, it might as well be a foreign language. Mm. And as you pointed out, it doesn't matter if you can read it.
I thought I had them dead to rights. And these bureaucrats, they just like, no, we do whatever we want here at the zoning board.
Yeah, that's right.
And you'll kiss our butts.
Peon. Surf.
You'll slave. You'll do what we say.
Yeah. Why label them citizens? Oh. Why not just call it what it is? You're a serf. You're a slave.
Free Talk Live. 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern. Live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here and bring up whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE, the live Saturday edition of the program. That's 855-450-3733. Also, you may join us via Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Send a contact request. We'll approve it. And after that, you can easily get on Free Talk Live.
ExpressCoin.com is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Whether it's Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin, they've got several others over there, too. They make it fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. I don't think you'll find too many of their competition out there are the same. So you can get your cryptocurrencies with confidence, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, at ExpressCoin.com. They've even got an app you can download for your smartphone over at ExpressCoin.com. If you use coupon code FTL... when you purchase your favorite cryptocurrencies over there, and you get less than $40 worth, there'll be no fee at all at ExpressCoin.com. So again, it's ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL. That's FTL as in Free Talk Live. ExpressCoin.com.
Let's go back to Brendan in Kentucky. Brendan, you had another question for, I think, Mark or myself regarding this discussion that you brought up, actually. I think it was a good question about what would things look like without this government one-size-fits-all monopoly court system in the realm of, like, family law, in the realm of mom and dad having a dispute about a child, that kind of thing. And go ahead with whatever your other point was or question.
I was going to say that, and I'm sorry, I still haven't got you guys straight yet.
I'm Ian Freeman, and Mark Edge is the guy who read the article earlier tonight.
What I was going to say to Mark is that it sounds like you're suggesting kind of, you know, the most obvious solution is to break it down so that we don't have one huge state deciding how everything's going to be for everybody and localize it a little bit. Is that kind of accurate?
My first step is let's make things fair. So with our current monopoly judicial system that we have, men should, you know, people of different genders should be treated the same. So men should be able to have the same period of time, or at least a similar period of time, to decide they don't want to be fathers that women have to decide that they don't want to be mothers.
Yeah, but fathers and mothers isn't the only issue with terminating a pregnancy. Like, I don't think that that's I mean, I agree with you about that, but at the same time, you know, a man's never pregnant. So.
But what's it have to do with anything?
Well, it has to do with whether or not a woman can terminate a pregnancy.
She certainly can. So can this guy, apparently. He did.
Well, he can, whether or not he should.
Indeed. Should. There's a lot of getting the should down in this particular instance is very complicated. Well,
just to, for our listeners just tuning in, this guy poisoned his girlfriend.
Basically, well, poisoned her in the sense that he gave her some unauthorized abortion pills that caused her to abort a 12-week-old fetus.
Unauthorized by her. She had no idea, right? Like, she was poisoned.
She'd be the one to authorize it.
Brandon, anything else you want to share tonight? Thanks for the call. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Doug. He's in Utah listening to KOAL in Price. Hey, Doug.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Welcome.
It's Doug. Price. I appreciate you taking my call.
Of course.
Second time caller, long time listener. Love your show.
Super. Thanks. Go ahead.
Hey, I like the topic today. I'm a 54-year-old guy. I've been through a lot of this. The abortion stuff you're talking about. I had a marriage that was a little turbulent, and in my early 20s, my wife was about 4 years younger than me, got pregnant. She didn't want to have the child because it would ruin her body. I tried to take her to court to keep her from aborting my child, and the court said that she had every right to do whatever she wanted, even though we were married.
I agree. I think she does have every right to do. I don't know, Mark. I don't think Mark agrees with me on that. But well, I find her body; she can do what she wants.
I find it a very difficult question to answer I've been asked here, so I want to make sure that I get my answer out. Is that I think that prohibition on abortions has been tried, and it was really sort of a bad thing in history. So I'm not proposing abortions. Prohibitions on abortion. But I, at the same time, believe that. Look, I am not. I should not be the judge of, who gets to live and who dies. And as far as I'm concerned, all human life is human life.
Well, that doesn't really address what he was saying.
A little bit differently skewed than where I'm coming from. The abortion issue isn't my problem.
Right.
The right to choose between parents is the problem. You know, we were married.
Yep.
Okay? And for her to have all the legal rights in the legal system to choose what she wanted to do. And under the rules of law, I believe that as her husband had the right to that child every much that she did, but the courts didn't see it that way.
No, they didn't. I imagine
so
they wouldn't.
You didn't want her to have the abortion. She wanted to have the abortion.
No, I did not. She wanted to have the abortion for whatever reason.
Mark, do you think he should have some legal say in whether or not she has an abortion?
You're asking me to live in a world
while we are under the covenant of marriage, okay? Yeah.
You're asking me to make an arbitration in a system that I do not agree with. I don't think she should be able to make the decision to abort her child, sadly.
I disagree completely with you there. Doug, good call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Found definitely a point of disagreement here. So what you're saying is, Mark, that when two people are, whether they're in a marriage or not, you don't think the lady should have control over her own body?
Oh, I think she should have control over her own body in the sense that she had control over her own body. Like the ramifications for your actions. If I take a knife and cut my finger off, slice at my finger, it's a reasonable possibility I'm going to lose a finger. Mm-hmm. If I go out and have sex, it's a reasonable possibility I'm going to have a child. Even though I have a vasectomy, I'm still going to be responsible if for whatever reason things don't work, right? And I still have a child. I'm responsible, even though it wasn't my reasonable assumption that I was going to have a child. So I'm simply saying that, you should be responsible for your actions, and that includes taking responsibility for your body. Now, if a woman's going to die from having a child or something like that, I think that that's a different circumstance. But all in all, I think you should be responsible for your actions.
Well, okay, I'm not saying you shouldn't be responsible for your actions.
Sounds
like you are. This is a separate issue from whether or not abortion should be legal. You already agreed that it should be because prohibition doesn't work. And let's come up with, if you don't like abortion, come up with some more creative ways to convince women to not have them. Offer to buy the baby or something like that. There's creative solutions here that could work. And of course, science could also come up with some way to sort of take a baby from a lady or a fetus from a lady and then grow it in a lab.
I imagine that's coming, right?
Yeah. So, I mean, there are going to be some solutions here. But with the idea that abortion is legal and, you know, whether or not you want to make a moral judgment on that, that's another question. But you're saying that you don't think that a lady, under a situation where it is fully legal for her to have an abortion, should be able to make that choice?
No. That's not what my claim is. My claim is that it should, like, you know, since we're in a paradigm, you're asking me about, there's some variables here I don't agree with. I don't agree with the variable of legal, and I don't agree with the variable of killing. So it's two variables. I can't really make an assertion in this because I don't agree with either of them. And
but
I have
sounded like the assertion you made, and maybe I misunderstood you, was that she should not be able to have an abortion.
I don't think,
if
I
he
don't
doesn't
think
want it.
Anybody should be able to kill a child.
It's a fetus, not a child.
When does it become a child? When it slides
some
through
point,
some point
like
of
that.
Part of meat. So you're saying on the day before a birth that a woman should be able to kill her child? Mm. You know, like halfway out, chop its head off, that kind of thing?
I don't know. I don't really want to get into the details because everybody's going to determine that time frame differently.
Indeed, they
Everybody
will.
Everybody has their own opinion about this.
That's why I say that I can't make that determination. That's why I go ahead and choose the moment of conception.
Mm-hmm. Right, but it's legal to do that. As far as I'm concerned, it's her body. She should be able to make a decision about that. And if you don't like it, then you shouldn't have stuck it in there in the first place.
Let me ask you this.
If you don't agree with the decision that your lady's going to make, you shouldn't have knocked her up.
Well, let me ask you this one. So you're dealing with two governmental systems here that compete without controlling land masses, as we've been talking about, sort of voluntary governments. And one of them is the, you know, God, guts, and guns, you know, governmental system where they believe that every child is a child from conception on. And the other one is the We Kill Kids agency.
Okay.
And they go ahead.
I guess
you're
going to want to check the ID card in advance of having sex with that person.
You're really going to. It's a big issue.
Buyer beware. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And that, you know, that door swings both ways. There's more coming up here in moments. You can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoin by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait.
On account. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me.
Property.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free to bring up whatever you want. The live Saturday edition continues here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
Don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com. If you enjoy what we're doing on Free Talk Live, then please shop with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the links you'll find there, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase. Whatever it is you buy, Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. It means it's just a little bit of less profit in Amazon's pockets, and we get to keep it. So you get the same great prices, same great free Super Saver shipping, Amazon Prime, all that. This huge selection, the reviews, everything you're used to with Amazon. You're just entering through our affiliate link, so that way Amazon knows we sent them the business. And whether you're Amazon US, UK, or Canada, we've got links for all of you over at shop.freetalklive.com. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. Johnny's in Huntsville, Alabama, listening to WBHP. Hello, Johnny.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Oh, man, I want to speak of the abortion thing, man.
The what?
Yep. I just want to say that, you know, I'm really against the abortion thing, you know, and what he did, you know, it was wrong. And, you know, we don't supposed to take no life, just point blank, you know what I'm saying? And
what you're saying is the man who poisoned his ex-girlfriend with some abortion pills in a smoothie, that was what you meant when what he did was wrong.
Yeah,
there's no doubt. I don't think anyone's going to disagree with that, right?
Like, there aren't many.
That's pretty clearly wrong. I mean, that's you're essentially poisoning somebody in that case. She survived, but you don't have to die in order for it to be a case of poisoning.
Exactly. And then, you know, as far as conversating on that situation, I think we should go a little bit more deeper into the feeling of love, you know, about us as Americans. You see what I'm talking about?
In the feeling of love, is that what you said?
Yes. Yes.
He was Norwegian. Should he not feel love?
Well, say that again.
He was Norwegian. So was she.
Meaning this happened in Norway?
Yeah, the coupling people up as far as we as Americans things, just I'm just saying.
Hello, we as human beings.
We as human beings, because the lines are just, these are just lines on maps.
Right, but I have to speak of Americans because we are Americans and we going through more things than people in different countries, you know what I'm saying? And I'm talking about after the war, the Obama thing. I mean, as far as living in general, you know what I'm talking about? This is big, but it's also little because Americans doing a lot of killing, man. You know what I'm talking about? We killing ourselves, man. We're supposed to be loving ourselves and saving ourselves. We're supposed to be Christians, you know what I'm talking about? We're supposed to be the ones that's falling behind Jesus. Where is this?
Well, I do share some of your concerns, Johnny, that certainly the United States government is not very Christian. They are going around killing people around the world. And thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. And I do like the idea of focusing on love. I mean, gosh, that's not a bad message at all, whatever your religion. I think that most religions that I've encountered, at least, that I've learned about, have a real appreciation for the idea of love. Now, whether or not they actually put that into effect in their own lives, that's another question. Because if you are a Christian and you're trying to be like Christ, which is the whole point, as I understand it, of being a Christian, is to attempt to emulate that man, then you should be loving your neighbor. You should be forgiving those who trespass against you. And we don't see that from the American government. In fact, the people in the American government and governments around the world, but the U.S. government's particularly egregious in this, is that, you know, they go around going around invading other people's lands, killing innocent people, and at the same time wearing crosses around their necks. I mean, it's a sickness. Don't you agree, Mark?
I don't think the government wears crosses around
the people who are in the government. Mark, I'm not talking about...
Right.
There are a lot of
there are
Christians.
No governments, right? There are organizations of people that claim for themselves, you know, some sort of legitimacy.
And many of those people claim to be Christians while at the same time engaging in murdering human beings around the world. As long as the government tells them to do it, as long as people calling themselves the state have given an order, somehow they think Jesus is going to be okay with that.
I think that I think there's a real problem for Christianity, for Christians following the Christian religion, to follow any government of man, frankly.
Absolutely.
When you claim to follow the King of Kings, how you can follow you know, governments of man, I think are very complicated. You know, there's those verses in Romans, which I think it's 13, that complicate the situation. But you know, I've got lots of questions. If you're supposed to follow the governments, are you supposed to always follow them? What if they're wrong? There's been plenty of instances in the relatively recent past where states around the world have been wrong. The U.S. government, you know, thought it was okay to go killing Indians for a long time, owning black people.
Yep.
There's, you know, women not being able to own property.
Right. Was that what God wanted? Right? If you believe that?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I suspect God didn't want that.
Yes. Toll-free number here, 855-453. I know that my God would not want enslaving other people and would not want people to be treating others poorly.
Well,
because my God's got a love. Now, I don't know about yours, but that's how my...
I'm with you.
Yeah. So let's continue here. Let's go to Aaron. He's listening in Albuquerque, to Kiva. Hello, Aaron.
Hi.
Hey, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Thank you for taking my call. I wanted to just say that I'm a secular agnostic, and I'm ardently pro-life. And I just wanted to let your listeners know, and you guys, that there's a website out there. I'm not involved with its creators or the organization behind it. It's secularprolife.org. And one of the arguments that was debunked on that website, in a way that convinced me, is, at least, is the pro-choice argument that abolition of abortion leads to the deaths of women seeking illegal abortions.
Okay.
And I know that's counterintuitive.
Tell me about the debunking.
The details are a bit hazy. One thing for me, it's been a while since I read this website. I heard the show on my car radio. I wanted to dive in. But one thing that does stick in my mind is that Chile, the South American country, they abolished abortion some time ago, several decades back. They're under immense pressure from the U.S. government to reverse that, and they're slowly doing so. But the maternal mortality rate was reduced sharply by the abolition of abortion in that country, and you can get more details that I don't recall.
The mortality rate is generally something that would only be reported in legitimate hospital beds and things like that. If you go and you get a back alley abortion and you end up dying from it, you know, that may not necessarily get reported in the same way, right?
Again, I can only refer you to this website, secularprolife.org, and, and also the penalty in Chile when abortion was abolished, the penalty for a doctor performing that procedure was the same as for the murder of an adult. So, you know, you can't really deduce a lot of empirical data as to rebut your what you mentioned, that the deaths getting reported would be legitimate hospitals doing the reporting. But you would have to assume that the deterrence would be much higher in a country where the penalty for a doctor performing an abortion would be the same.
Well, but we've seen that the whole deterrent effect doesn't work. I mean, generally, punishment is a very poor way of disincentivizing people from doing stopping them from doing what you don't want them to do. Certainly, there's plenty of punishment in the United States for drugs, for instance, and there's no shortage of drug use and no shortage of a black market there.
That's quite different from a killing. It's quite different from a killing. And also, I would suspect, and you
what's quite different from a killing? What do you mean by that?
You guys are making different arguments.
In other words, you know, if I go into a supermarket and shoplift because I'm hungry, there's an impulse there. That punishment is going to have a harder time deterring than when you have a doctor who's already in a high position in society being offered.
No. I don't think you understand the black market. I don't think you understand the black market. So thank you, Aaron, for your call tonight. It wouldn't necessarily be doctors in high positions that would be doing back alley abortions.
Likely they wouldn't. Those aren't the ones handing out the scripts for hydrocodone or whatever, right?
The back alley abortions would be performed by, in some cases, not very professional individuals whose job, you know, they'd figured out some way, whatever the way, coat hanger, I don't know what they would do, but some kind of dirty, unsafe, horrifying sort of black market abortion. I mean, look, the drug world is littered with dishonesty. It's littered with people who are offering product that isn't what they say that it is. And that's because they're offering it in the black market. There's no real way to hold these people accountable. You can't go out there and say, hey, I got a bad deal from this drug dealer, because you'll get arrested too. And so people keep all of that stuff underground. Any disputes, they're usually settled with violence. And so in the, you know, the black market abortion world, these are going to be women who are seeking seeking this service, and they will do some undesirable things in order to acquire it for some undesirable people who perform the service.
So the punishment is only a deterrent if it is meted out on a relatively regular basis. Speeding tickets are terrible deterrents because cops catch you 1 out of 10,000 times you speed. However, speed cameras on the side of the road, people tend to go pretty slow by those things, because they hand out a ticket to everybody.
855-450-FREE. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, March 14th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.67 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,159 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $284. Antiwar.com reports the U.S. State Department has announced their latest round of non-lethal aid for Syrian rebels, and while couched as an attempt to support the Syrian opposition, much of the money is going to pet projects to try to rile up international support against the Assad government. $15 million of the funding is going to journalists and opposition figures to support documentation of war crimes, human rights violations, and other Syrian government abuses. The State Department has been keen on this, hyping abuses committed by the Assad government for years, initially in an effort to build up support for a failed U.S. invasion, and now seemingly just to keep that window open. Despite talking up a $70 million figure for the non-lethal aid to rebels, the rebels themselves appear only to be getting about $25 million worth of gear, with the rest going to journalists or self-proclaimed governments in exile to try to buy credibility. Much of that will be going to the Syrian National Coalition in Istanbul, which has virtually no backing by any armed rebel forces anywhere, but is still regularly bankrolled by the U.S. government to keep their lights on while they hold endless meetings over who is going to be leading their ultimately powerless group. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports Indiana police called to a Walmart store in Muncie said they discovered an active meth lab in the men's restroom. The Pendleton District Meth Suppression Team said the workers at the Muncie Walmart called police about 11:30 p.m. on Thursday when a suspicious backpack was found abandoned in the men's restroom. Officers discovered the backpack contained an active methamphetamine lab, and the meth suppression team was called in to dismantle the apparatus. Investigators donned protective respirator masks and suits to remove the chemicals from the store. The health department determined that both the men's and women's restrooms would have to be decontaminated by a company specializing in meth lab cleanup before they were reopened to the public. Investigators say they were working to identify the owner of the bag. Indiana State Police said meth dealers are increasingly leaving labs in public places to cook rather than risk explosion or contamination at their own homes. They said the dealers leave the chemicals to cook and later return for the finished product. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports pro-government labor unions and social activists staged demonstrations across Brazil on Friday in support of President Dilma Rousseff 2 days before mass protests planned against her administration. The leftist leader is facing a wave of discontent over a stalling economy, unpopular budget cuts, and a corruption scandal over kickbacks at oil company Petrobras that has implicated 4 dozen politicians from her governing coalition. The protest on Sunday could deepen a political crisis that has been given rise to calls for Rousseff's impeachment for not stopping a multi-billion dollar graft racket for Petróleo Brasileiro, as the oil company is formally called. Police said 12,000 people blocked one of the main avenues in São Paulo, Brazil's largest city, marching in the rain to defend the state-run oil company and workers' rights threatened by belt-tightening economic policies. Turnout in other Brazilian cities was smaller, and there were no reports of any violence. The demonstrators had contradictory slogans. While backing Rousseff, the unions called for the withdrawal of her measures to reduce unemployment and pension benefits, part of an austerity plan she has had to adopt to bridge a gaping fiscal deficit and save Brazil from a credit rating downgrade. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
With weather conditions in the Sahara among the most brutal in the world, the desert is a place suitable only for collapsing, dying, and rotting. Starvation is just one of the many possible outcomes for the gazelle or desert elk. It could also suffocate in a sandstorm, collapse of dehydration, or be run over by a dune buggy. Only the vulture has the wherewithal to survive in this nirvana of death. They feed on the dead of the Sahara. Uniquely adapted to the rigors of desert life, the vulture usually dies of heart disease after becoming overweight from the feast of carcasses. The landscape of the desert is dominated by towering sand dunes made from millions of years of ground-up bones. Another day ends in the Sahara, Earth's largest, most uncomfortable tomb.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. We invite you here to take control of the airwaves and bring up whatever might happen to be on your mind on the live Saturday edition. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, looks like more restaurants are closing their doors in Seattle as the minimum wage approaches a big jump to $15 per hour. We can talk about that. You can also bring up whatever you'd like to discuss here. We are also available on Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. Tonight on the microphones, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. For those of you just tuning in, last hour, Mark, you shared with us a disturbing story of a man in his, was it mid-20s, I think, essentially poisoning his ex-girlfriend with some kind of an abortion pill. And she was 12 weeks into pregnancy at this point. Poisoned her with this abortion pill, and he's now facing 7 years in prison over it. Kind of brought up a larger conversation about, you know, what the family courts might look like in the absence of a government monopoly and just abortion and rights in general. Let's talk to Gary. He's in Myrtle Beach, listening to WRNN-FM. Hello, Gary.
Hey, how are you guys tonight?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I was just listening, and that gentleman that was married and his wife got pregnant and wanted to have the abortion and all, and just wanted to throw something out there. It seems like that the whole situation about abortion, you're never going to get this country to come to an agreement on it. So that just needs to be dealt with straight up. But as far as the rights of the woman, it's her body. She should be allowed to decide what's going to happen. That's all fine and well on however you stand on it. But let me just put a scenario out there. You got a man and a woman has consensual sex, and the girl wants to have the abortion, but the boy or the man doesn't. All right. Well, he has no say in the matter because she can go and do whatever she wants to do.
That's right.
But let's reverse it. Let's say that the girl gets pregnant and the woman wants to keep the baby, but the man wants to have the abortion. Well, she can again choose not to have the abortion and have the child, but then she can come after him for child support and all these other issues that just, you know, don't seem right. If it's a two-way street, and I understand how people feel about women and their rights and all this and all that, but men should have some rights as well. It's a two-way street when it comes to consensual sex, and if a pregnancy occurs and they can't come to an agreement on it, then what rights do men have?
No, the answer is not many, right? I mean, you know, where?
Exactly.
Well, you have the right to get a vasectomy and then not really have to probably worry about those issues in the future. I mean, that's what I did.
Well, but I mean, what if I wanted to have a child in the future, but maybe not under those circumstances? You see,
be very, very careful then.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, look, I understand where you're coming from, but, you know, until you can actually transfer the fetus into the man, you know, if the guy wants to have the baby and she doesn't, then you're pretty much SOL, right? Until a guy can actually carry that baby to term on his own volition, whether it's through the miracle of science in some sort of test tube or like a, you know, what was it, the movie
well,
with Arnold Schwarzenegger?
If he could carry that pregnancy in his belly, would she then be able to decide when he aborted it? I mean, I don't think that anybody, male or female, should be forced into an abortion. I think that the real issue comes along when somebody's forced into pregnancy, essentially, and that by our legal system. And I think that that's that's what needs to be addressed.
Gary, anything else you want to share?
Yeah, and that's my whole point. The fact is, there's accountability on both sides. You can get a vasectomy, but then you're kind of, you know, screwing yourself out of anything in the future. But women have to be held accountable to a certain level but for what they do as far as a sexual act goes. And if they have a sexual act and they
there's a lot of accountability on their side, too. Biology exactly. gives them a lot of accountability in the sense that they're more likely, you know, they have to deal with the pregnancy one way or the other, no matter what the legal ramifications are. And they also have
right,
to
they're
deal
the ones getting sick in the morning and you're not.
And also they have to deal with the issue of they're more likely to contract venereal diseases than men are. You know, they're receiving as opposed to giving, as it were. So There's consequences on either side. I see the point you're making. It's just that I don't think that women are running around being irresponsible. I think we have a broken legal system that all genders are dealing with.
Hey, Gary, good call. Thanks for making it. Appreciate your thoughts. Let's talk to Nick. He's in Charleston, South Carolina. Nick, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, I'd like to make a couple of propositions.
All right.
The first one being that man and woman need each other to stay alive on the planet.
All right, I don't think that's true anymore.
I just need food and a place to go to sleep. Some water.
As
I can stay
species,
alive.
As a species.
Yeah, I got gotcha. You.
All right, I suppose.
Okay.
I don't think we have much trouble. The species is growing pretty well.
Well, no, but I get what he's saying. It's a general statement, yes, that this time you need to have men and women having sex to propagate the species. Okay, it's true.
I think that the male gender has been dropped to the point of irrelevancy. At this point, all we're good for is a paycheck, reaching tall things, lifting heavy objects, and the occasional sexual interlude. Yep.
Well, that was part of my second proposition was that man is a sentient natural resource of labor.
Yep.
And woman is a sentient natural resource of more humans. And the conclusion is that man and woman have some sort of interest in what each other are doing. In other words, a woman, if a man is digging a hole in his backyard to no avail, why wouldn't the woman be saying, can't you be doing something more productive?
I can't imagine
not
she
nagging.
Isn't.
And likewise with the man. If the man has conceived a child with a woman and the woman wants to end the pregnancy, doesn't the man have a certain interest in saying, well, I thought we were going to start a family?
You thought wrong. I mean, yeah, there's an interest, but ultimately you got nothing. I mean, you, it's
at
not
some
your
point,
baby.
One person's going to have to be able to make this decision. Sadly, with the you know the constraints of biology as they exist today, one person has to be able to make a decision. Who's that person going to be?
Nick, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate your thoughts. Let's talk to Michael in Virginia Beach, listening to WNIS. Hello, Michael.
Hello. My question is for Mark, and I'm going back to how the conversation started at the. In the first hour, my question is this. What if the father of the child, in the case that you first cited, is a man committing adultery with a married woman? Are you saying that by paying child support for 18 years, he has assumed his responsibility for having had sex with another man's wife?
Well, I don't think another man has a wife. I think that really the only responsibilities for cheating come on the cheating partner. So I don't think that, for instance, if you and my wife get it on, I have no dispute with you. Unless we're friends, in which case we would cease to be friends, perhaps, depending on how the situation goes down. But my dispute would be with my wife. You understand?
Well, here's the problem with that. You're trying to figure out what the responsibility is for the quality of life on planet Earth, because it all stems from the sex act. And the only entity in the universe that has a right to determine what the responsibility is for the sex act is not you Jerry Falwell types, but the Most High God himself.
I'm not sure how I got to be a Jerry Falwell
type. What do we have anything to do with Jerry Falwell?
You sound exactly like him. You're making up your own rules just like he made them up. He had no respect for what the Bible says. He was out here trying to save.
Well, you just said that God got to make a decision. Now you're saying the Bible gets to make a decision. Which is it?
No, I said God makes the decision.
Well, then which is it? So why do I care what the Bible says if God makes the decision?
Because God clearly authorized the writers of the Bible to write what they wrote.
I don't think that's very clear.
Yeah, I'm not sure how clear that is either, because there's been a lot of different Bibles with different translations and interpretations.
There's other holy books that claim to speak for God, too.
If there's something in this world that is unclear, I would say the Bible falls in that category.
God, the most spoken for entity in the universe.
All right, there's more on the way here. Thanks, Michael, for the call. 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to talk about I don't really want to talk about abortion. God's fun to talk about, though. It's Free Talk Live. Bring up anything.
His hair was falling out in clumps.
Petey stopped eating, and all his hair fell out.
Mounds and mounds of fur all over the place.
Our hairballs have hairballs.
Our golden retriever, Sundance, he scratched incessantly. There was hair all over. I heard a radio advertisement for Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids, zinc.
There's flaxseed oil,
the seaweed, the kelp,
the digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Within 2 weeks, the shedding slowed down to almost none. The scratching went away after a few days, and Sundance's coat was starting to get shiny and glossy the way it had when she was a puppy.
Tons of energy, no more bad smell.
If your dog has shedding, dry skin, excessive scratching, the phone number for Dynavite is 859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, more here now with you. If you want to call in to bring up anything you want at 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733, or we can talk about the stuff that we've been discussing, the issue of this guy poisoning his ex-girlfriend with some kind of an abortion pill in a smoothie, which apparently was successful. The baby, she had a miscarriage, and now he may be facing 7 years in prison. There's been several threads that have come off of that. I'm not going to recap them all, but you're welcome to comment on whatever you like here at 855-450-FREE or via Skype at username lrn.fm.
Many people are concerned about the U.S. economy, the direction that the government's going. Some of their solutions are to leave the country, give up their citizenship. If you want to take perhaps a less radical tack, you might consider just having sort of a bug-out space outside of the country. I think that's the idea behind FortGault.com. Fort Gault is not some kind of vast estate in a foreign country or anything like that. This is really much more like a condo building or a ski resort that has some really cool amenities, a makerspace full of tools and a restaurant and a bunch of places to relax and socialize. The living spaces are rather small at FortGault.com. But it gives you a space, and they'll also give you the opportunity to rent those that same space out when you're not using it. So it's sort of a functional hotel to some extent, too. Go check it out. I think it's really worth it. They've got some great-looking videos there that you can look at FortGault.com. It's a well-put-together website. I think you'll be as impressed as I am with the way it's put together. There's only room for 100 people in this project. By the way, it's in the south of Chile, and it's FortGault.com, F-O-R-T. GALT.com.
Let's go to the phones and the fun, where ladies come first here. Allie is in Aberdeen, Washington, listening to KBKW. Hello, Allie.
Hi.
Hey, you're on the air.
Yes, I only heard your last caller because I drove down to Starbucks. But anyway, I'm sitting here in the parking lot, and you were talking about the Lord. So I like to talk about the Lord, and I was going to share with you what he's been talking to me about, and that's the four blood moon.
I didn't talk anything about a Lord. I was talking about God. I mean, I don't see God as anything separate from
Lord
me.
God
so,
is to me one.
Lord sounds
Lord
like somebody
God
who's ruling over God. You.
Hmm? The Lord God is many. I think of him as the creator.
Uh-huh.
But my God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. There's many gods. There's many gods that people worship. Some of them worship the American Idol. But the thing the Lord's been talking to me about is the four blood moons. And this month, I wanted to tell everybody. I called you 2 years ago. I don't know if you remember me.
Nope.
But I was telling you about those four blood moons. And
don't they have a shirt with some wolves on it? Is that related? The three wolf
moon? I don't think so,
moon?
No.
No, okay.
No.
What's a four blood moon? What does that mean?
Well, we have blood moons all the time. It's an orangish-red moon. But the four blood moons that I'm talking about are the ones that, over a course of 2 years, are on Passover, which is the spring. And it's going to be April 4th will be the third one in this tetrad. Tetrad means four.
Uh-huh.
But this month, March 20th,
tetrad means
is
four?
A solar eclipse.
Okay.
Yeah. Four in Hebrew means earth completion. Like 40 means testing and trial. 8 means new beginnings.
What's going to happen?
She's right, by the way, Mark. Tetrad does mean
okay,
a group
great.
Of four.
I've never heard it before.
So, yeah, what's happening here? So you're saying there's been four blood moons within a certain time frame, and that means something to you?
It does. The thing that sets these apart is there's only been three before. We're in the midst of one right now. There was the first tetrad, which it takes a course of 2 years, was 1492 and 1493. And they have to be on Passover and then the fall feast of Sukkot or Feast of Tabernacles, then Passover and then that. And then again, and a blood moon, God put signs, it says, and I know you don't, well, I don't know if you know the Bible, but in Genesis it talks about how the sun, the moon, the stars are like signals. And the Hebrew word is O-W-T-H, oath. And in the Bible, it talked about how when there was the flood, the Lord Creator put the rainbow in the sky to, as a reminder, he would never destroy this creation with a flood.
I'm really interested what light spectrum worked like before that.
Let's not get off track here, Mark. It's difficult enough to really understand where she's coming from.
Sorry.
So let's see if we can kind of compress the story here. So four blood moons.
I was thinking today about, like, when you were in junior high and high school, you learned about the continental drift, where the land looked like, we don't know, it's a theory, that at one time, if you look at it, all the continents looked like they were one land mass.
Pangea.
And then they drifted apart.
It's a good theory.
You remember that from high school?
Yeah, that's a good theory. Sure.
I don't know whether it's a good theory or not.
It seemed plausible.
I tend to believe the scientists if they say it.
Well, you know, the Jewish people were some of the first astrology people, and that's why astronomers is the word they want, because...
This does sound a little bit like astrology, but you still haven't gotten to the point. I'm going to try to hurry you along here. We do want to talk to other people, but I do want to understand what the relevance of these four blood moons is. What do you think?
What's going to happen?
Well, I know that the solar eclipse, it's going to be a full solar eclipse on March 20th, is to the Gentile nations, and that's us. We're not Israel. We're the Gentile nations, and God is going to be speaking to the people on Earth.
How's he going to do that?
And that's March 20th. Well, he sent the Holy Spirit to Earth when Jesus was here, God's Son.
So I can just expect to hear something in my head?
Well, I don't know if you ever received the Lord, because if you don't have the revelation that Jesus or Yeshua is God's Son, then you may not have the Holy Spirit.
You're gonna burn
the people who do have the Holy Spirit.
So you've been talking to God. You said you've been talking to God.
But I'm a Gentile too.
Hold on. You said you've been talking to God. So you've kind of gotten advance notice on this. But you're saying that other people are going to be encountering God or the Holy Spirit on March 20th? Is that what you said?
I said that the people who have the Holy Spirit, who believe that Yeshua or Jesus is the Greek, is the Son of God, they were sent the Holy Spirit when he left Earth. He was only here for 33 years, and then he died on the cross. And he said, you wait, and I will send you the Holy Spirit to lead and guide you. The people who have the Holy Spirit that are on Earth, and it's his Holy Spirit.
Now, this always happens. You're getting off the subject. Are you saying this always happens with the four blood moons? Is that when God comes back to speak to people?
Nobody knows. Nobody knows.
How do you know?
We only know by appointed times and the signs he gave in the book of Matthew.
So
Matthew was the chief.
Are you saying the last time the four blood moons happened, which was in the 1400s or something, that God did not speak?
That was the last time. That was the first time. That was the first.
The first time. Why do you think that March 20th is going to be the date that God comes to speak to people?
It's a solar eclipse, and I'm just taking it from a Hebrew perspective. We don't think that way in the Western world, but in the Middle East. God gave the sun, the moon, the stars to speak to us.
All right, I've heard enough. Thanks for the call, Allie. You're repeating yourself. Thank you. 855-450-FREE. That's the
I'm just
going to
follow God on Twitter.
Mark, you was it God on Twitter?
Oh, yeah,
Twitter
God's
slash
on Twitter.
God?
Absolutely.
Is it Twitter slash God or Twitter slash God?
You just look him up, God. He's on Twitter. I mean, really, this whole Holy Spirit thing clearly can be misinterpreted, right? I haven't heard about these blood moons up to this point.
Yeah, I was
say, raised a Christian.
You were raised a Christian. You went to Christian school. And you read the Bible a number of times in your adult life as well.
I mean, I guess. Yeah. Yes, I did. I read it three times.
You didn't catch anything about the blood moon.
No,
I mean, there's a lot going on in there. So
It's this big, complicated book.
Looked it over.
It can get a little boring at times, too.
855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Do you believe that, lady? We're coming up here. You can also bring up whatever you want, for real. It's Free Talk Live, Saturday show.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We invite you to dial toll-free here. It's live Saturday edition of the show. We're live 7 nights a week, by the way. You can always grab archives galore over at freetalklive.com. And with you in the studio tonight, it's Ian here.
And Mark.
Want to invite you to check out ProXPN. That is one way to protect yourself, and it's an important one, to protect yourself online. It is a VPN provider that's a virtual private network. Their network's global, by the way, so you can connect to different locations all around the globe and protect yourself because, well, first of all, they encrypt your data. So everything coming in and out of your computer is encrypted by ProXPN, which means that if you're, let's say, sitting at a coffee shop and you're on your Wi-Fi, your laptop or your handheld device, somebody could be sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets. If you aren't encrypting all of your data, then some of those packets are going to be unencrypted, and they could be possibly revealing usernames and passwords and things like that. So you want to protect yourself. ProXPN can do that, and with their premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, private torrenting ability, plus you can get past regionally blocked websites with proxpn.com/FTL. You go there, download their software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, or Android, plus Linux, proxpn.com/FTL, and they protect you from people sniffing Wi-Fi packets, your ISP saving your surfing history, governments possibly snooping as well. So this is very,
possibly,
very useful. Yeah, there's a good chance of that. But if you've got ProXPN, there's a much smaller chance of that. Plus, you can always combine ProXPN with other technologies like Tor for extra super anonymity factors. So proxpn.com/FTL, use code promo code FTL50, and you'll save 50% off the price of their annual account, which, by the way, that savings lasts as long as you keep the account. So when your first year renewal comes up, you'll get the same great price from ProXPN. It breaks the price down to about $5 per month when you use code FTL50. And by the way, there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. You have nothing to lose but your privacy, so don't wait. Go to proxpn.com/FTL and use promo code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. Zoe is listening in Charleston, West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Zoe.
Hi. My call's not going to be as entertaining as Allie's because I want to go back to the abortion thing, so sorry about that.
That's all right. Go ahead.
Yeah. Well, I'm a 33-year-old mom who has been on birth control since I was 16 because I did not want to have a kid or have to face the abortion right or wrong issue. And then we accidentally had a break, had a kid, and I guess my partner, when he was in his early 20s, got his girlfriend then at the time. They, together through consensual sex, got pregnant.
Okay.
And she did not want the kid, and without really talking to him about it, had an abortion. And as someone who has myself never wanted a child, but had a child, and I do the depo shot with the birth control where it's every 3 months,
mm-hmm.
We actually went in to get the shot, and I took a plan B, and I had a negative pregnancy test that was a blood test, and yet I was still pregnant. It was in that small window where he was alive enough that the plan B didn't kill him, but he was not alive enough that he showed up on the birth control test.
Interesting.
Whoa. So I went in 3 months later. Yeah. So I went in 3 months later. I was like, oh, I think I'm pregnant, but I can't because I took the plan B and I'm on the birth control. But I went in 3 months later to get my shot, and they did another test, and I was pregnant.
Unusual
so.
Circumstances.
Yes. I mean, he just wanted to, he's a bad, I don't know if you can say ass on air, but he's a cool kid. I mean, he wanted to live.
And it's so a miracle, right? I mean, you tried to kill him.
Is.
He lived through it.
I know. Well, it's incredible. And the thing is that we're not having another kid.
Mm-hmm.
And I just keep thinking about the fact that my partner had a child at one point that he wanted to keep and she didn't. And so our little boy had a brother or a sister, and now he doesn't have a brother or sister because one parent wanted to love the child and keep the child and make the child grow, and the other parent didn't want the child and didn't want the child to grow. And I think that that's what it is, because as a woman who has never wanted to be pregnant and who had to go through a pregnancy, we had a natural birth at home in a pool. It was awesome. There was no pain. It was me and the midwife and the doula and Adam, and he went to work at the bike shop. He owns a mountain bike shop. And, you know, it was just time, and we had the kid, and it was great. We had Kentucky Fried Chicken afterwards, you know.
This is a nice story.
And I think with abortion, whether or not it's legal or not, a dad should have the right to bring a kid into the world, because, you know, if a dad has the heart and the love to do
but
it.
But that would mean that the dad would have to be able to somehow stop the lady from controlling her own body, and that just doesn't make sense, right?
Well,
he's got the right to bring a kid into the world, but you got to find someone else who agrees.
I think it's a very sad circumstance, but
talk
I don't have any solution for it.
Talk about this stuff with your girlfriends. If you have a conversation with your girlfriend or boyfriend and they say, I don't want a kid,
right,
and you want a kid, you should probably end the relationship.
Exactly. Well, and that's the thing, is that they didn't want a kid. But then when faced with the issue, that's the thing, is that sometimes your plans, you're like, I do not want a kid. And then all of a sudden you have a kid and you're like, shoot, you know, we have a kid. And then you're faced with a decision. It's that life and death decision. I'm a veteran. People know sometimes you have a life and death decision and you have to pull the trigger or not. And sometimes when there are two people involved, as a woman who went through pregnancy, yeah, it sucks. Yes, she at some point needs to take responsibility for her actions and understand that in her actions she had sex with a man, and that both of them 50-50 brought a life into the world.
Unfortunately, and you don't get a 50-50 decision to get rid of the life. And I understand the desire to have that. But it's just never going to be that way, right? Like, because she controls her own body, and if she wants to go out and, you know, get a back alley abortion, there's nothing that he can do about that. So I think the only thing you can do is use discretion.
But not moral. That, I mean, that's true.
That's true.
Where I sit on it, on the issue, too.
And Zoe, thank you for the call. I do appreciate hearing from you tonight.
I think it is very common for people to switch over their opinions, as you know.
Under the circumstances?
No, when they have kids. Once they've had a kid, that they're likely to change their opinion when it comes to the whole abortion conversation. That's what happened to me. I think that they see the value. It really strikes them from an emotional standpoint. They see the value in this little being that didn't exist not too long ago, mm-hmm. and they see the sort of fragility of it, and it just seems appalling to end those things.
Yeah, I can understand where that's coming from, but I can also empathize with the person who sees the value in continuing on in their life without having a kid.
Oh, I can see. Really, I understand it. I used to, you know, you used to feel the same way.
Yeah,
but
that's why I got a vasectomy, because I see no value in having children when I don't plan to have them. And when you have a vasectomy, then you are in total control of that. And if you want to have kids, you can just go and adopt one anytime you darn well please.
There's plenty of guys paying child support for children that aren't theirs.
That's a good point, and that's a huge, huge problem with the system. There's more coming up here. You can, of course, bring up anything you want. Carson's in Macon, Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live. Carson.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me. I love the show.
Welcome. Go ahead, sir.
Just to touch on the abortion, would it not make sense to, you know, reach the common ground of we judge life and death by a heartbeat? Would it not make sense to judge the life by being able to detect that heartbeat?
There's lots of things that live without hearts.
That's true. You know, I haven't given it that much thought.
I think a heartbeat. The heartbeat is you know, one of the things that sort of comes earliest in gestation for humans, and oftentimes, you know, I mean, it. I think it's like 14 days, 17 days. It's a relatively short period of time, and many times that heartbeat will refer to by pro-life people, but. Frankly, as far as I'm concerned, when that zygote splits into two cells, that it's still got 46 chromosomes.
Right, I completely agree with you. My main topic for calling though was privatized police force.
Great, stand by. We'll get to it here. Hang on, Carson. We'll bring you back for that. 855-450-FREE. Anything to get us away from abortion. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on the live Saturday edition.
You wanted the topic, man.
Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's Mark of Free Talk Live, and I want to tell you about a new way to be prepared for emergencies. Not just big emergencies, but little ones too. It's a source of backup power, so small that I can put it in my pocket or the glove box of my car, but it's so powerful that it can actually jumpstart a bus if I need it to. Sounds crazy, but it's not. I'm talking about a breakthrough in portable power technology called the Pocket Power Plus. If you get stranded in an airport, in your car, or you just want to go off the grid for a while, the Pocket Power Plus becomes your own personal mini power plant. Run pretty much any kind of electronic device for hours, even days if you need to. The Pocket Power Plus can also deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power that can jumpstart almost any vehicle, even in the coldest winter days. Comes with free jumper cables and an accessory pack. Best part, my listeners can now get Pocket Power Plus for half price by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Use coupon code FTL to save even more. Go to PocketPowerPlus9.com, PocketPowerPlus9.com, coupon code FTL.
So who else will you meet at the Get Prepared Expo? For starters, from Republic Broadcasting, John Moore and John Stadtmiller. From GCN, Aaron and Brad Dakins, Joyce Riley, and me, Vincent Finelli. Joining us are the instructors whom you've learned to trust. Surgeon of the Year, Dr. Norman Shuley. Engineer, Matt Stein. The real Fox Mulder of the X-Files, Dr. Richard Allen Miller. Author and analyst, Captain John Reagan. Your counterterrorist from Central America, Mike Ma, dental center owner and my dentist, Dr. Howard Shane, radiation instructor, Craig Douglas, author and survivalist, Rich Sheban, author, Judy Dollarhite, cancer center owner from Mexico, Dr. Patrick Vickers, bug out expert and pilot, Captain Bill Sermo, beekeeper, Jeff Maddox, seedsman, Mike Knox, author, Gayla Pruitt, author, Harry Cooper, food expert, Joe Acapinti, and Bill Whaley, the junk man, March 27, 28, and 29. GetPreparedExpo.com, the largest preparedness and survival expo in the USA.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free to bring up what you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number, and you can join us via Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out in that way if you like. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And don't forget that coming up, the Texas Bitcoin Conference, it's right around the corner. We're 2 weeks away at this point. So 2 weeks from tonight, Mark, you and I are going to be broadcasting live from Austin, Texas at the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. It'll be happening at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, March 28th and 29th. Keynote speakers will include George Gilder, who is a world-famous investor, economist, and author, plus Simbala Nair, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology. Jason King, David Johnston, Robert Murphy, Anthony DiOrio, Charlie Schrem, and others. Go and get the details and get signed up at TexasBitcoinConference.com. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use code FTL. You'll save $25 off the already affordable $150 price point. So go and grab your discount. Courtesy of Free Talk Live, just use code FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com. You won't want to miss the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon, which will be happening during the Texas Bitcoin Conference, plus the networking, getting to meet the movers and shakers in the Bitcoin universe. These events are great. And we were at the first one, actually, last year, broadcasting Free Talk Live from that event. We'll be back this year at the new location for it, right in the heart of downtown Austin. The second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference, March 28th and 29th. Don't forget to use code FTL and get a discount on your tickets. Let's go to Carson. He's back with us here in Macon, Georgia. Carson, go ahead. You had another topic that you wanted to discuss, so jump on in there.
Yeah, thank you. I got a bit off topic. I was actually wanting to get your perspective on privatized police force. I read an article... Some small town in Texas actually dissolved their local police department and hired a private security firm. That particular security firm had analyzed the crime and targeted those specific areas and supposedly reduced crime by 60%. I see an advantage as there's no government bureaucracy to hide behind. No way to
legitimacy of the badge too. You know, at that point they're
exactly.
Essentially private citizens operating, trying to keep people safe. Therefore, operating in a way that they don't have this unaccountability that what we call not sovereign immunity, but qualified immunity that many government bureaucrats have, including police officers. So I think that there's advantages in that way.
Carson? I see the same advantages. I just something doesn't strike me. This doesn't sit well with me about a privatized police force, though.
Here's what doesn't sit well with me about it. What doesn't sit well with me is that whenever the government privatizes something, it's always handed. They hand a monopoly. Excuse me. They hand the operation of a monopoly, which was whatever the government service was, whether it's privatizing a road or privatizing the police or you fill in the blanks. They hand that monopoly over to a private company. And there are definitely things I think that make it better than having it the government run that monopoly, but it's still a monopoly, and that's what makes me uncomfortable about it. It's a monopoly being granted to one corporation, and that's not okay. It's not true market competition, and as long as that monopoly isn't subject to competition and it's not subject to the market signals of being able to have customers leave, because that's the ultimate market signal is – I'm out of here. I don't appreciate the service you've given me. I don't want to come back to Walmart or Target or whatever store or product that it is that you might be buying in the marketplace. This is a product that you will still be forced to buy. It's being run by a private company now, so you could argue that it is a slightly more accountable, but it's still a monopoly.
And the private company, it doesn't take that much to put together a security company. There's lots of them in America.
But if you do that right now, you'll be arrested for creating a gang.
No, you put together a security company.
If you compete with the police.
Hold on, Ian. Let me finish what I'm saying here. Is the town or county or whatever can hire another agency relatively quickly if they don't like that. So there is a modicum of competition in the marketplace. Also,
a modicum, though.
The private organization is competing against just reinstituting a police department, too. So
that's true.
So competition exists. I'm not going to call it good or perfect or anything because people have a difficulty opting out. But the organization of the town, there's competition for the placement as security agency.
That much is true. But if it's a good old boy network, then there's probably not much competition there at all. It was probably given to some buddies, some city council member's pal. Was likely the person who got the deal. So, Carson, I share your concerns. Anything else you want to share with us?
Nope.
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate that. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
It's like the argument with charter schools and, education vouchers. You don't have the option of not paying property taxes for education, but people do have the option as to where they're going to send their kids to school. So, there's some competition, and it has resulted in some better things.
Let's continue with your calls and talk to, I think we got Melvin. He's in Alabama, in Huntsville, listening to WBHP. Hey, Melvin.
Hey, guys. You all have a great show, man.
Thanks. Go ahead.
I really appreciate the callers, too. I hope this doesn't sound too dumb, but a friend of mine and I were very curious about when we encounter people from the Middle East down here in Alabama. At the service stations, I don't know, I don't know if it's like that in your part of the country or not, but most of these people seem to be from the Middle East, where you get your gas and whether they're Iranians or Indians or Iraqis or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Pakistanis.
Well, we assume that these people, we know that they're originally from the Middle East. Okay, we're under the impression that the Jews are originally from the Middle East. Why are they white? And the rest of these people, you see this color in their skin. I have a two-part question. Why are the Jews, if we are talking to Jews, why do they look like regular white people, but the other people from that part of the world seem to have color in their skin? And why do so many people around the world seem to have so many problems with the Jews or don't like them? I hope you all can help me with that.
Okay, so the first question, I've actually talked to other Jews. I'm Jewish by, just dint of some genetics, but not wholly Jew. One of the theories is Ashkenazis, this is the white Jews, because there's also Sephardic Jews, which is basically says they look like Middle Eastern. Sephardic was that. Mm-hmm. That's what that means. So Ashkenazi Jews, one of the theories is they interbred and just decided to continue the calling themselves Jewish. They moved to Europe and interbred, and that's why they're white. I think that seems like the most reasonable choice. Some Ashkenazis will claim, no, we didn't do that. In fact, we are a special tribe of Jews that happen to be a little lighter skinned. And, that's the other theory. So I'm going to take choice one, but I just wanted to present choice two. Why don't people like Jews?
Some people.
Yeah, some people don't like Jews because I would say that integration has been an issue over time. Many times, people are different. People have always disliked people that are different. So, and many times, Jews, since they have a different religion and often dress differently, they don't integrate well.
I would say that, thankfully I don't encounter this. I don't know anyone in my life who is bigoted in that way. So, I don't have any personal.
I'm talking about historically, not
experience
currently.
With it. Well, I mean, there's still people currently who don't like them, and a lot of reason why some people don't like a certain type of person, whether it be their religion or their skin color, usually just has to do with something as simple as they were raised by some bigoted parents, and it was just passed down year after year, and it all stems from what you pointed out, Mark, is that at some point somebody said, those folks over there are different from us, we should hate them. And I don't think there's really any really intelligent answer to that question as far as, why do people hate, fill in the blank.
Well, their neighbors, the neighbor that...
Yes, sir?
Those people seem to have a problem with them. Wouldn't you agree?
Who has a problem with who?
Palestinians.
The neighboring countries around Israel. I thought back in the early, mid-40s, whatever... Israel whipped up on several of those countries or in a war.
Yes.
Some war,
well, the problem there's been a few wars. And
don't confuse a problem with a government with a problem with a religion or, a group,
ethnicity.
A race or something like
right.
that.
Right. So I was answering a different question. I didn't realize that we were talking about Israel. I thought we were talking about just sort of people that were ethnically Jewish. So with Israel, basically... Some politicians after World War II decide we need to divide the Middle East up into areas, and they say this is the spot for the Jews, and gave it to the Jews. Now, that's a little I can understand why some people might not like that. If somebody comes along and says your house belongs to somebody else, you're probably not going to like that. Now, if that somebody else won't give it back to you, you might come to disagree with that person and hate them or something like that. And that's really what happened there.
Melvin, thanks for your call. Appreciate it. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We've got plenty of time. An entire hour remains on this live Saturday edition of the program. It is Free Talk Live, and the toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. Plus, we've got Skype. Skype on in at username lrn.fm. More coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, March 13th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,156, up $2. Silver opened at $15.54, down 5 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $292.58. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. In the news, a post office in Colorado has been found using hidden cameras to record the license plates and facial features of customers leaving. Fox 31 Denver investigative reporter Chris Halsney confirmed that hidden cameras and recorders owned and operated by the United States Postal Inspection Service were being used in Golden, Colorado, outside of Denver. The camera was found hidden inside a utilities box around Thanksgiving 2014. A spokesperson for Postal Inspection Service declined to confirm or deny whether the camera was collecting data for specific cases. After the camera was initially reported, it was removed. A new bill that would restrict the ability to film the police and create a dangerous definition of media has been introduced to the Texas House of Representatives. Texas House Bill 2918 would require individuals filming or recording the police to be at least 25 feet away, and those who are open carrying would need to be more than 100 feet away. The bill also sets the standard for filming police to only radio or TV media outlets that hold a license that has been issued by the Federal Communications Commission. A new Gallup poll highlights Americans' growing discontent with the United States government. A poll conducted from March 5th through the 8th asked 1,025 American adults what the biggest problems Americans currently are facing. 18% of those polled said the government was the most important problem. 11% listed the economy, while 10% said jobs were the biggest issue. 31% of Americans said they were satisfied with the state of the country. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX to get free brokerage for the first 7 days. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to save big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, March 13th, 2015. Make sure you check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Texas State Representative David Simpson has introduced a new bill that would require Texas water supply systems to display information related to water fluoridation on their websites. Texas House Bill 1581 would require the amount of fluoride, the name of the company supplying it, the combined amount of fluoride in the drinking water from all sources, the annual cost of adding fluoride to the drinking water distributed by the system, and more. If passed by a vote of two-thirds of all the members, the bill goes in effect immediately. If the vote passes with less than two-thirds, it will go into effect September 1st, 2015. Two new parents are in the midst of a national tour promoting the use of Bitcoin and highlighting their experience raising a child with no birth certificate or Social Security card for the Undocumented Human Tour. Alma Summer and Brian Stith are traveling with baby Neo, who was born October 17, 2014, without a birth certificate or Social Security number. The family is traveling from Southern California to the Bitcoin Summit in Arizona and the Texas Bitcoin Conference in Austin. They're also working on connecting the decentralized network of individuals who do not submit their children to government documents for proof of birthday and location of birth. You can follow their adventures on their blog online at undocumentedhuman.com. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Schrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich. March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat.
for Friday, March 13th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
You are nothing more than the reflection of a grim, pitiless world, and this is The Onion Week in Review. Following the Supreme Court's ruling on same-sex marriage this week, overjoyed gay couples in Florida rushed out of their homes to have their marriages denied to them. Homosexual couples throughout the southern state told reporters they were ecstatic over the landmark decision supporting gay rights and said they couldn't wait to wait in line and have their requests to be rejected by their home state. And in science news, scientists probably discovered a frog or something. They're always doing that sort of shit. In other news, an 8-year-old boy surprises his Marine father during a firefight in Afghanistan. Johnny Depp is now physically unable to walk unless whimsically teeter-tottering across a rolling log, wobbly plank, or swaying beam. And Silvio Berlusconi is transferred to a steamy, all-female penitentiary. If you're seeking a celebrity interview, stay away from that bastard Tobey Maguire, who apparently can't even pick up a phone to say he has a schedule conflict and won't be able to make it into the studio. For more, keep checking TheOnion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live as we kick off the third hour of this live Saturday edition. The we includes me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And you can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features waiting for you there on the site. Totally free. Again, freetalklive.com. The minimum wage coming up to $15 an hour in Seattle, and restaurants are already closing their doors before it even goes into effect. We can tell you more about that if we get the chance, which we may not, because lots of people want to talk about stuff that they want to discuss. So let's go to the phones and the fun and start out this hour with Paul in Searcy, Arkansas, listening to KSMD. Hello, Paul.
Yes, hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we got you fine. Go ahead.
Okay, good. All right. Well, I have to stand outside to get reception, but it's a little better tonight anyway.
Well, thank you.
I was going to talk about the four blood moons, but the fellow brought up the Jews and why everyone hates the Jews.
Not everyone hates Jews, only bigots and racists.
Why so many, and it takes them by surprise? And historically, okay? And anyhow, while Muslims in the Middle East are destroying Orthodox Christian churches, villages, cities, running people.
Just to be clear, that's a really unfair statement. There may be some Muslims.
Let me finish. I'm not trying to. The Vatican had a synod of bishops from the Middle East and North Africa 4 years ago who blamed the existence of the state of Israel and the Jews for all of the unrest, even though all of it has come from Islamic fundamentalists. My answer to the guy in Alabama would be that God said everybody's going to turn on the Jews. And even with our nation presently, we've never been so disparate with them, at least their administration. But the four blood moons, the first occurrence, and they do happen regularly, you could say, but the first one in our modern times was 1492-93. In that year, Spain outlawed being a Jew and living in Spain. You could buy or you could leave.
You could what or leave?
You could convert, be killed, or get out. Spain did that, which at the time was the most powerful nation in the world, until 1588 when the Spanish Armada was sunk. Okay, the next time the four blood moons happened was 1948-49. Does that ring a bell? The first year of Israel coming back as a Jewish state.
Okay.
Okay? That's 450 years between those, so it's somewhat remarkable. Okay? The next time it happened again was 67-68. Does that ring a bell?
Was that the war?
The Six-Day War, which reclaimed all the territory of old Jerusalem, or old Israel. Yeah, and they got Jerusalem back as their capital.
Okay.
There seems to be a pattern here. 2014 and 15, you've got four blood moons, which the lady was trying to say has to do with relates strongly to Israel.
But you don't know what's going to happen, right?
It's a judgment.
The judgment day?
Okay. It's a judgment of coming. It's a judgment of sorts.
Okay, so you're not claiming that Jesus is going to return with a trump and that Christians are going to rise up?
Hey, if it happens, that's going to, you know, so. But the solar eclipses,
it's not gonna happen.
There are two solar eclipses also.
Okay.
On Jewish feast days in this period. The odds of the four blood moons plus the two solar eclipses, very unusual. Matthew 24 talks about the sun turning.
So how long do I have?
Dark in the mouth. Hey, make fun if you will.
I'm happy to make fun of this. Every prediction so far for the end of the world has been wrong.
I'm just telling you.
I'm just asking you how long I have.
He doesn't know. Only Jesus knows. Thanks, Paul, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. Look, so there's a website here, Mark, endtime.com. They've got a long, rambling screed about the four blood moons here. They claim there is going to be a new Holocaust.
So Jews are going to be killed? Is that what we're talking about?
They claim
lots of Jews.
They claim
millions.
Here you have to go a ways into this particular story before you actually get to the claim. But they say that there's going to be some sort of a peace accord between the Palestinian state and the Israel state.
Well, that wouldn't be unusual. There's been several of those,
and that the people are going to integrate, and then the Palestinians are going to turn and murder the Jewish people.
All right,
that's what they say.
Okay,
four blood moon.
Yeah.
But, you got anything?
Well,
I read the Bible.
This crap isn't in the Bible. Okay, so there's lots of end times conversations to go on inside and outside of Christianity. This is just part of that conversation. I can't comment on it because so far everybody who's talked about it has been wrong. Paul, the most prolific author of books of the Bible, claimed that it was happening soon. I consider that, you know, therefore to be a sort of a failing of the Bible already when its most prolific author, especially in the New Testament, claims that Jesus is coming soon, and so far it's been 2,000 years.
So here's what they propose, Mark, on this website, endtime.com. What do you do, right? Like, so they say, we must warn them. They say, the Jews of Judea do not realize the extreme danger that lies just ahead. They don't believe in Jesus. Consequently, they don't study the New Testament. Yet Jesus obviously wanted the Jews of Judea to be warned. He spent several verses of his prophecy telling the Jews where the persecution will take place and blah, blah, blah. Anyway, then apparently their plan is they're going to send their own end time magazine to every Israeli home if they can roust up enough money to do this. There are 2.27 million homes, they say, in the nation.
Why magazines? Why not just send an email? They're cheaper.
And they're going to try to, I guess, you know, try to explain to them how they're wrong and that if they don't listen to them, they will all perish.
Well, that'll help.
Let's go to your calls here and talk to, we got Josh in Detroit. You're on Free Talk Live. Josh. Josh in Detroit. Going once.
Yo, what's up?
Josh, you're on the air. Go ahead.
What's up, guys? All right, so I was going to bash on the guy that was just ahead of me, you know, talking about the whole Jesus and the Bible and all that. First of all, I don't believe in all that. I'm a universe kind of guy.
Okay.
You feel me?
Yeah, I feel you, man.
Yeah, you feel me?
I've never felt
so
you.
So I just want to talk. You promise?
Just go ahead,
go
man.
Go ahead, man.
Dude, you don't make me lose my train of thought.
Yeah. Take notes.
Am I a stoner?
Maybe.
Yes.
Okay.
No,
oh, yeah, totally.
I am.
All right, get to the point.
I am. No, it is the point. Get to the point.
Getting high
exactly.
Is the point?
Yes.
All right. Thanks for the call, Josh. Where's my bong hit sound effect? I'm sorry. I'm so bad. I'm so bad with the sound effects being a producer of the show and a host at the same time. Shame on me.
I got to say that, you know, when it comes to marijuana smokers, I find them far less dangerous than alcohol imbibers.
There we go. I'm just way too late with that, but for what it's worth.
He told us he loved us. That's really nice, you know?
Thank you. I love you, too. Let's talk to Dana in Grand Rapids, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. I love all of our listeners. Dana, go ahead.
Dana, too.
Hi, guys.
Yeah.
Hi, guys. That sound effects were great. but I guess
better late than never.
I guess because we live in America and the First Amendment, everyone, including Josh, has a right to embarrass himself on a national radio program. So,
I don't think you have a right to come on here and embarrass yourself, but we will let you. How's
that's
that?
That's true. I consider it entertainment.
Okay, thank you for the correction. You know, Ian, you made a comment to Mark I'm going to try verbatim here. Mark, you were raised as a Christian. Did you ever hear about the blood moon? And I have a response to that. I'm a Christian, too, and raised that way. And the one thing that the Christian faith, whether it's minister, I'm not going to say rabbis because they don't believe, they believe in the historical Jesus, some of them, but not the, except for Messianic Jews who believe that Jesus Christ was truly the Son of God.
They're pretty rare.
That exception, they make. Right, exactly. I don't disagree with that. But they might believe in the historical Jesus, but not that he was the Son of God. They're still waiting for the second coming, which unfortunately for some will be the last. But you know what? Our churches, whether they're priests or ministers, to respond to what Ian said, I'm not surprised you didn't hear about the four blood moons.
Stand by. You can explain, because I didn't hear about it when I went to church either. Maybe it's like a fundamentalist thing?
You should have put this in Bible school.
More coming up here. Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
If you're the parent of a man-child, you know how frustrating it can sometimes be. The piercing sound of his video games waking you up at 2 in the morning. His insatiable hunger and inability to cook anything for himself. The messes he makes. The stress can be overwhelming.
Something will set them off, such as their man-child will tell them that they don't know how to tie a tie even though they're almost 30. They'll start shaking them and yelling and saying, "What the hell is wrong with you? Why don't you get a real job instead of working part-time at a board game store?"
The results of shaken man-child syndrome are devastating. Trauma caused by the brain colliding with the inside of the man-child's skull can lead to cognitive disabilities, making it even more unlikely he'll finally marry the girl he's been having a long-distance online relationship with for 6 years. Or it can even lead to death.
He's not spilling cereal all over the couch or leaving his beard clippings in the bathroom sink intentionally. He truly does not know what he's doing.
For the Lab Report, I'm Stuart Adams.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. The live Saturday edition continues here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, you can join us online at freetalklive.com.
Get a free pound of coffee by going to coffee.freetalklive.com. There, you can sign up for a subscription program. You can cancel at any time. And your first pound will be free. Now, you'll have to pay for the shipping, but you can cancel at any time. Like I said, it is great coffee. It's 100% organic. It's shade-grown. And it's top 1% grade Arabica beans. This is the best of the best coffee. You will likely never have a better cup of coffee. It's BuzzBox. And what BuzzBox does that's different than other high-end coffee makers is that they give us back some of the profits so that we can give them to charity. Now, what we've chosen is Kiva.org, and that's an organization that gives out microloans to people around the world because we believe in giving a hand up, not a handout. So if you want to help us give microloans to people all around the planet, We've I think it's been 14 countries or something like that. People who, you know, want to buy used appliances or fix their cars so they can fix their taxi cab, I should say, or buy cows, those kind of things. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com, upgrade your coffee drinking experience, and give back. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, we're back with Dana in Grand Rapids, Michigan. There, for those of you just tuning in, there was a strange call last hour about this four blood moon thing. Apparently, it's actually fairly well known. We've had three or four calls about it so far tonight. It's some people within the Christian religion believe that these blood moons that happen every certain number of years, that they are somehow in coincident with the things happening with Jewish people, specifically the nation of Israel or that area of the world. And Dana, you're calling to share your thoughts on it with us. Go ahead.
Okay, I have several things, and I'll help clarify this. First of all, the blood moons. Now, remember, earthly time is not the same as celestial time or heavenly time.
How many hours are they off?
Well, I'm not sure. Nobody knows this.
Okay.
But those who have gone through those life after death, you know, where they're pronounced clinically dead, and I'm talking from a scientific standpoint now, they have said that that time there is completely different. So just because a fourth blood moon happens, it doesn't mean it's going to be the end right away. Another thing I wanted to say is it's a sign. It doesn't mean the end, but that we're supposed to look, we were told, it says in the Bible, we're supposed to look to the heavens for signs. So blood moons are signs. And the other thing is, remember, Christians need to remember, and I am one.
What is it, but before you go on, Dana, what is your Christian upbringing? Where do you learn about this blood moon thing? Because I was raised a Presbyterian.
I didn't. And that's what I was going to address. The reason why Mark, probably Ian, made a correct statement in saying Mark probably never heard about it, because I think back in the olden days, the doom and gloom preaching from the pulpit isn't what people want to hear. They tend to go away from that. The message is more positive. It's more, you know, I'm sure Mark has heard this when he was raised as a Christian, that we're supposed to be ready at any day. You know, we're supposed to keep ourselves in a state of grace so that at any time that we're called home, then we're ready to go. And so that's why
nobody knows the day or the hour.
Tell me, right, and only the Father knows. Even the Son said that. The historical Jesus said, no, the time, just the Father knows. So for people to say it's March 20th, now, maybe a blood moon will happen March 20th. I'm not one to say, but what I'm saying is, it is one of the signs we're supposed to look at all or signs, that we will have signs, so we're going to be able to prepare. But I can't stress enough that our churches are doing a grave disservice to people, you know, like myself and Mark, and because they're not, you don't have to doom and gloom and pound that damn pulpit, but you need to address people. You need to tell them, this is what you're doing wrong, and you need to do this to get there. And they're not addressing it. It's more like, okay, everybody, you know, rose-colored glasses and sunflowers, and let's all be ready to go. Well,
so you're saying you don't want doom and gloom, but you do want some doom and gloom.
You need some reminders. You don't need to threaten and horrify.
Well, that's what all Christians do. I mean, that's what most Christian churches do, is they threaten people, right? Like,
no,
if you don't join our
actually,
religion, you're going to burn in hell. I mean, that's a threat.
No, no. And if they do, they shouldn't be saying that, because aren't they going to be surprised when there's a whole lot of us up there from all different faiths? But
oh, so you don't subscribe to that belief system? That's interesting.
Well, I will say one thing that I'll tell you, and I don't talk, I'm a very private person, so I'm going to share something with you. I am a Roman Catholic, and our faith, you know, that now if this is true, and I do believe it happened, the historical Jesus and my Jesus, my Lord, the Son of God, said, "You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church." Now, I'm well aware of our history, both from a historical standpoint and the history of the Catholic Church. For many, many years, the Dark Ages especially, there were some crazies that were popes and priests and bishops.
So is it the Catholic viewpoint that people of, is it the Catholic viewpoint that people of other faiths will go to heaven?
No. A lot of people say that about Catholics. But because other churches are man-made, God, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, started our faith. But here's the thing.
How do you know that?
I absolutely believe. I said that's what our belief is. But somewhere in between.
Well, I think they all believe
Jesus
that or
Christ,
whatever. Thanks, Dana, for the call tonight.
No,
I appreciate
it.
Toll-free, not good enough. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, you know, it's unusual to come across someone with a Christian viewpoint that actually thinks people of other faiths will end up in heaven. That's
I don't think that's unusual at all. It might be unusual for them to call a talk radio program.
Okay.
But, no, I think that
I thought the whole thing behind, you know, Christianity was you either join or you perish hell for all eternity.
That'd be the hard sellers.
That's
I would
not
say
the pitch.
The vast majority that would not say that, no, that they would say that people of other religions and people that were too young to accept God would, you know, as Jesus is their savior or whatever, would still go to heaven in many cases. That has to do with you know,
good acts.
Not good acts, but sort of the righteousness of your heart. It gets really complicated in this issue. Remember that if all the kids that didn't that if life begins at conception, and all the kids that never had a chance to accept Jesus as their personal savior, that 90% of heaven is fetuses that were never born. So
what
you
a
have
party.
Yeah, you have this really sort of strange scenario going on when we talk about heaven anyway. These are issues of faith, and I try not to mess with them. The only issues I particularly have with Christianity are, A, I'm not that fond of the Bible as the religious book, and I certainly don't think it's that the unerring word of God. B, I think that hell is a threat, that when you talk to young kids about hell, that it, you know, you're...
You better be good, Johnny. You're going to burn forever.
You're really filling their head full of a bunch of crap, and they need to, a loving father isn't going to send any of his children to hell.
In the same way that I don't think loving fathers would beat their kids either. So the toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733.
A loving father, and I've got to say, I've thought about it.
If you love that which you created, why would you want it to be tortured? Doesn't make sense to me. 855-450-FREE. You dial toll-free and bring up anything that's on your mind on this live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. We've got Skype as well. Skype username here is lrn.fm. We're coming up.
St. Paddy's Day is coming soon to Guns80.com. My buddy Mark is rolling in clover since Guns80.com announced its clean and green sale. He used his leprechaun-like magical powers to get Guns80.com to offer us a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Now, for a limited time, when you order an AR-15 rifle kit, Guns80.com will toss in a cleaning kit and a tactical bipod pistol grip free, all for the low, low price of $449.95. Go to Guns80.com. That's Guns80.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here to bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
Live Saturday show, and you can join us online at freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing, then one of the things you can do to support Free Talk Live, shop with us. You go to shop.freetalklive.com, enter Amazon, you'll find the links there. It's easy to get to. shop.freetalklive.com. Free Talk Live gets a cut. Also, you can amp the show at amp.freetalklive.com. It's $5 a month to amp Free Talk Live. You get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, amp-only podcast, the amp-only Facebook group, which is very active. In fact, I just posted the video that is the video that will be hopefully maybe the final version. I don't know. I'm still trying to put the finishing touches on this idea of raising some money to get Free Talk Live back on in Africa, back on satellite, back on free-to-air satellite. So as an amplifier, you get to see stuff like that. This is kind of the behind-the-scenes stuff we're working on, what's coming next with Free Talk Live. So we've got...
You're really part of the organization that way.
If we've got something to share with you, you'll know it first if you're an amplifier. And so you're kind of on the inside loop there. You can go and become a Free Talk Live amplifier, get the perks. over at amp.freetalklive.com. It's $5 a month, and it makes a big difference for us when you do it. So thank you. ampamp.freetalklive.com. Right back to your calls and thoughts. Syphase, listening in San Francisco. You're on Free Talk Live. Syphase, going once. Syphase, going.
Hello, do you hear me?
There you are. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, sorry about that.
Go for it.
I wanted to call about corporations, and, you know, it's a common theme sort of in the Liberty community that corporations are bad, and they have all these extra privileges granted to them from the government. And I wanted to argue that they're actually not.
They're actually what?
A problem. That they are not actually a problem,
okay,
in the way people will usually say they are.
All right.
And that all of the supposed privileges they have would actually exist in a free market as well.
Okay.
Explain that.
So I just sort of get your guys' opinion. Like, what do you guys think of as a corporation? Or what...
What's my concern as far as corporations go?
What do you think defines a corporation?
What's that?
What defines a corporation? Well, it's a file folder.
In your opinion.
It's a piece of paper that's issued by usually an organization calling themselves the state to sort of issue what they consider to be legal personhood to a business or a concept that is something that is separate from the humans that are involved in that business. The legal person of the corporation can be acted upon legally with lawsuits and things like that, which creates a layer of protection for the individuals who are operating that corporation.
And is that the only thing? I mean, are there other attributes that you would say are unique to corporations or that sort of are in...
Well, I guess what's unique about a corporation is that the government considers them to be people. They call them persons legally, and they supposedly have rights, which, of course, is ridiculous.
Well, they're also eternal.
That's true. They live forever.
Or at least immortal.
Yeah.
In the sense that they don't die the way humans do.
So I guess let's take each of those one at a time. So the idea of having, you know, some sort of legal abstraction that, you know, can have shareholders and, you know, this thing can own property, or you could have a bank account in the name of the corporation.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, do you think there's something particularly objectionable about that?
Well, not a bank account. I mean, at that point, you're just talking about sort of a fictitious name. People will run sole proprietorships under fictitious names, and that's not particularly a problem. I don't think that if you open a haircutting place that if you're that you're trying to hide your identity as Syphase from people, if you call yourself Sheer Madness, that you're in fact just trying to get people to come in your door because Sheer Madness is a better name for a hair cuttery than Syphase.
Right. So the aspect of a corporation that is that, you know, it's sort of this fictional entity to where if you have an account and, you know, you can have an office building in the name of a corporation, I mean, do you think that this fictional entity should be able to own property, or do you have a problem with that?
I don't have a problem with people getting together and owning property. What I have a problem with specifically when it comes to corporations is that, for instance, if E and I open a corporation and we bilk a bunch of people out of money, and as long as it's not criminal, then we can just, and people want to sue us civilly, we just, dissolve the corporation and say, oh, there's nothing left to sue, and we go on our way. That's
certainly... That's the biggest issue, and that's the one I was planning to get to last.
I think that's the only issue that I can think of.
Yeah, that's really the issue, is the protection of sort of the elites, if you will, from liability for actions.
Then in that case, I guess I'll just jump right to the end. So what exactly do you think that protection does? I mean, what does it protect you from?
So here's an example. If you've got a car that's in the name of one corporation and you've got a house that's in the name of another and a business that's in the name of another, if somebody goes after the business for whatever purpose, you know, maybe they've been wronged or damaged or harmed in some way, then the car and the house are untouchable because it's in the name legally of something completely different. So even though that person who might have been involved in the business should be held fully liable for whatever it was that went bad, they can't extract from them the house or the car as part of that.
Can you be more specific as to what would go bad? I mean, are talking about if someone's involved in a corporation and...
I don't know. It could have been embezzlement. It could have been theft. It could have been somebody getting injured on the property. I mean, there's all kinds of legal issues that could come up. And I don't want to make it sound like I'm an expert when it comes to corporations. I just know the basics.
And I'm certainly not an expert here as well. But so from what I've found, just doing some basic research, the aspect of a corporation that people think about where your liability is limited, that's only something that protects shareholders in the corporation from the liabilities of the corporation. So say, for example, if you're a shareholder in Acme Corp and the Roadrunner decides to sue Acme Corp because they've been working with the
I get where you're coming from. You're saying the shareholders would be protected from the actions of the people in the corporation, which makes sense. I mean, that's not their choice. They don't make the decisions as shareholders on the day-to-day business, so that makes sense. And also, I have read provisions in corporate, I don't know if it's code or whatever, that do say that the board members of the corporation, if they do something illegal, can be held legally liable for those actions. So it's not a across-the-board protection, but it is a way to organize your assets in a way that can protect those assets. And, I mean, that's useful from the perspective of the person who's trying to protect their assets, especially if they're being come after by some government or some other aggressive agency. But if they're a person who's using the corporation to protect their assets because they're planning on scamming somebody or, doing something of a nefarious nature, then the corporations also can be used to protect that person. I mean, and ultimately, the people that get most protected by the corporations are the ones who know the system the best. I mean, a lot of people don't know anything about corporations. They don't even understand... Right. This is the first time they've heard any of this.
So I was kind of going in that sort of direction. Is that,
you got 10 seconds.
Nobody can do it.
It's hard to defend. I mean, really, corporations, there's a lot about them some things about them are indefensible. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll say this really quickly that, I don't agree with, all the laws around corporations now, but I do want to try and defend them. Very basic idea of
sure, there's nothing wrong with having a business. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with having a business with its with having a business with its own identity separate from the humans, but more coming up.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lots to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour, 2 times faster than Claritin, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service, and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. We may have enough time for you if you're already on the line. If not, you can always get on with us tomorrow night because we do the show live 7 nights a week. You can join us online anytime over at freetalklive.com as we go jump right back into your calls and thoughts. Jeff's in Elgin, Illinois, listening to WRMN. Hello, Jeff.
Hi. Have you guys heard about the Geneva Bible?
Yes.
I have not. What is that?
1599.
Yeah, this is a version of the Bible that came prior to King James.
Exactly. It listed the sins of the king in the marginal notes, which, of course, the King James did not like, and so he put out the 1611 King James version of the Bible. Now, why would
wasn't there a 1614 version too?
I'm not aware of it.
Okay.
Offhand. Okay. So anyway, he didn't like the having his sins listed in the marginal notes, and it's my understanding that that the Pilgrims actually brought the Geneva Breeches Bible to America. The reason it's called the Breeches Bible is because it talks about the fig leaves. It uses the term breeches or britches. And so the King James Version is kind of a government propaganda sheet. And I just wrote down notes here. The Pilgrims and the people that founded America did this from the Geneva Bible, which is more freedom-oriented, and they would not have accepted the King James one even if it had been given to them. And now you guys mentioned Romans 13, 12 or 13 or something?
Yeah, the one that says that basically you got to follow Hitler because God put him there.
Powers.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay. Thank you. So anyway, people could look up, you know, some of this stuff. Okay, so the preachers are tax exempt, the churches are tax exempt, and I used to go to a I went to, you know, a Christian school, and they, it was part of a Baptist church, and they were independent fundamentalist. And okay, so it's ironic that they would stand up and pound on the pulpit with the King James Version, and they say, we believe in the King James Version of the Bible, which believes in, you know, you being subject to the government, so that government, that the preachers are all tax-exempt, that means that they're state churches, and they're going to be ordered by the government. Now, this is an irony, and I'm going to tie this all together. Okay, it's my understanding King James was a tyrant, and it's also the information I've heard is that he was a homosexual. Now, this is ironic because the preachers, well, here's my point now. The preachers care. They say that they say that they're against those things, against, you know, both of those concepts, and yet they're probably going to be told, because they say you got to do what the government says, right? That's what they say, right?
Yeah.
Be subject to higher powers. Okay, so the government is at some point, I believe, will probably order the churches to marry gays, because right now you've got, you know, if you bake, yes.
I believe you're right.
Why do you think that's the case, Mark?
Okay.
Well, because at this point it's discrimination if an organization chooses, you know, not to participate in gay marriage or whatever. So I suspect it's just around the corner that the government's going to require churches to.
That would be a huge imposition on the freedom of religion if that were to happen. Jeff, thanks for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. By the way, I support gay marriage. I don't want to make it seem like I don't. But I also support the ability to choose, and that includes for the people performing the marriage to choose. If somebody feels uncomfortable performing a marriage for somebody for whatever reason, they should be able to say no. No, thank you.
Agreed.
However, Mark, I think one of the things that could lead to them being ordered to do that is that there is a proliferation of these state churches, these churches that have essentially asked for permission to exist from the state.
That 501c3 status?
Yeah, that kind of thing, where they've jumped through the state's hoops for the purposes of receiving some sort of a benefit or perception of a benefit from the state, and then all of a sudden, surprise, they find themselves at the behest of the state. They find themselves having to do as they are told. So that's why there's actually a free church movement out there, which is a group of churches who either are founded without any kind of, you know, state functioning at the lowest level, or they have incorporated over time, but then they unincorporate to try to get back to a more pure form.
Yeah, I'd encourage the Christians out there to check out the Geneva Bible. The things that I've read about it online make it interesting to me, but I don't spend much time reading the Bible, so anymore.
Let's continue with your calls and thoughts with Joe, listening in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Hello, Joe. You're listening to WTKG.
Yes, it's minimum wage issue.
Yes,
if a job is worth $15-$20, or there's a shortage of workers for a particular job, businesses will have no choice because of the market.
That's true.
But when these little townships and these cities start mandating stuff, I mean, how can they be surprised when companies start laying people off or little stores close up and move to the next city over? It's I'm against a minimum wage just on principle. I think it should be between two people, but you know, it's a lot of these protesters and stuff need to learn that a guy doesn't open up a little shop or a restaurant to be a social program. He's there to make money, and if you're a good worker, you'll probably get more if you're worth it.
Absolutely dead on, Joe. I'm glad you really hit the nail on the head that one, and we don't have to really dig into that issue any further for tonight. Thank you for the call on it. Appreciate it. Let's go to Pete. He's in Mobile. You're on Free Talk Live. Pete, listening to WAVH.
Yes, sir. I was going to ask you guys y'all's opinion on if the abortion act performed by the guy in Norway took place in the United States, particularly maybe one of the southern states, where the fellow would have been charged with murder. I think that's probably more relevant issue.
Yeah, he could have been. I think that there are cases where somebody's been charged with two murders for killing a pregnant woman.
Right. So that, to me, that's more of a confounding issue where the woman can kill the child by choice, and it's not murder. The guy kills the child, and it is murder.
That's the conundrum that the laws as they exist today.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, that's a conundrum.
Thanks, Pete. Appreciate your call tonight. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. He's referring to a story that we opened the show up with tonight, where a man in Norway poisoned his ex-girlfriend with some sort of an abortion pill. It wasn't Plan B. It was something else.
Yeah, something he bought on the internet.
And essentially created a miscarriage for her, and now he's looking
at 12 weeks, yep.
Years in prison as a result of that. James is in Arizona. You're on Free Talk Live. James, via Skype.
Yes, the first command in Genesis is to go forth and multiply. But I know I'm not the only one that's glad to hear that one stupid teenage girl that sleeps with a middle-aged man will never have a baby come out of birth canal like Lion Freeman that you're sitting next to, Minister Mark Edgington. But the Torah also suggests that if you accuse somebody of doing something that they never did or would do, that makes you guilty of it. So in my mind, Mark Edgington, that makes you a two-time loser as far as murder goes, which is an unforgivable commandment, by the way, if you ask me.
And what goes on in your mind is really not very interesting to me.
Oh, really? Really? I know it doesn't interest you. It should. Your rotten soul should. It does interest to me.
Yeah, like, well, you certainly spend a lot of time talking about my death.
And I'm not the one going online. Yeah. I'm not the one, by the way, spending time off air going online about a loser like you.
Oh, no,
Mark,
what I'm not spending any time.
May I take control of this call, please?
That's a lie right there, James. James in Arizona, because he does spend time off air going on about you, Mark. He sends text messages, not constantly, but often enough.
Threatening messages that I post on a site so that people can see them.
Liar, liar, liar. Their pants on fire. And yes, murderers go to hell. Murderers go to hell. And people that watch murders take place and give a murderer a lift to the airport, who, by the way, thank
you're
God
you're the one who wants to talk about killing people. You like to mention my wife and kid on a relatively regular basis. You are a lunatic, and all I'm doing is putting evidence online.
On your head, you liar. Keep on lying and digging yourself 6,000 feet under, you loser.
All right,
you just
6,
sound like you sound a lot like Jesus tonight. I gotta say, you are such a good Christian.
James wants to talk about what a great Christian he is.
And Freeman that smears people online and on air. Get a life, you loser! I only call it take you on. About the coalition of
Lillian. That's hilarious. Thanks for the call tonight. Oh, what a loving, good Christian that man is right there. Perfect shining example of exactly what Christ was teaching.
No.
Yeah, I'm joking there. But that kind of ties me back to the point I was making earlier about, what is it? Was it Gandhi who made the statement? I'm going to butcher and paraphrase this, but it's not
I like your Christ, I don't like your Christians.
Thank you for that. I like your Christ, I don't like your Christians. And that's because many of them are hypocrites, and they claim to follow Jesus, who was supposedly peaceful, and that was not a peaceful call, and he is not a peaceful man.
It's really difficult when you take on the mantle, take on a mantle like Christianity, which has a lot of adherents. People want to lump other people together. I don't think that Christianity is good or bad based on what James says.
Oh, no.
But I think that Christianity is very clear, and the Bible is very clear that love, joy, peace, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, these will be the fruits of the Spirit, and you'll know Christians by them. If you're not exhibiting those, you're not a Christian.
Christian. I don't know what you are.
That's my indictment from the Bible to you this evening. If you call yourself a Christian, love, joy, peace, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control.
We are out of time for tonight, but we'll be back tomorrow night. You can join us for the live Sunday edition at that time. And in the meantime, join us online at freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, March 13th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,156, up $2. Silver opened at $15.54, down 5 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $292.58. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by Express Coin.